So AWK is a very powerful tool on Linux operating system. So this can do pattern search and take some actions on that. So when we saw grep and we saw cut, in grep we were able to match the patterns, and in cut we were able to take out one portion of the file. But AWK is a very powerful tool. So how does it run? The basic format of AWK is like the command AWK, and then the pattern, and then the action on which the action has to be done, the file name. Sometimes the search pattern is depicted like between some slashes. So this can do actions on the search pattern. So with grep we saw it could search the pattern. With awk we can take some actions on those search patterns. So very first example of awk I would like to show is from my file cell data. So I created this cell data, and it's an exercise for you to figure out how you create the cell data from my original employees file. So in the cell data there are four columns: ID, first name, second name, and the salary. Now these four columns have a delimiter, and which is a space. So between each column there is a space. So if I see my original employee file, this is what the data is, and from this I have used some of the Linux tools commands to come up to this file. This is your exercise to come to get this file. Now let me do some uses of awk. So the very first use of awk is, let's try to see the list of salary of people. Okay, so let's say AWK, and I'm not searching anything, I'm just taking action. I'd say print, say $4, which is the column number 4, and the file name. So it just gave me a list of salaries. So by default, the delimiter is space. If we have to work with a different delimiter, I will show that option as well. But before that, I will just go ahead and do some more examples of awk. So the next example I'll show is searching a pattern and taking an action on that pattern. So for example, I want to use a classical example of find people whose salary is more than 10,000. So for that, I will say AWK, okay, and I will run some search, and search pattern would be from here. I'll just copy here. So it will search in $4. Okay, $4 is the salary for greater than 10,000, and then it will print the $0. Now $0 is a special thing here. Okay, $0 means it will print all the columns. So it went through the list, it figured out what are the lines where you can see the salary is greater than 10,000. Now similarly, if I just want to get the first name and last name and not the salary, I need to use $2, which is the first name. Then I have to put some space, which I have to use in double quotes. Okay. $2, then if I put just dollar space shift $3, it will give names in a in this format. It will ignore the delimiter, so I have to add some delimiter on my own, which would be in single quotes. I can give a space, so I'll get the names. This is how we can do pattern searching as well as apply some mathematics and show. Another example I will show you here is how can we find, or let's see, there is a, let's think that management has given task to increase everyone's salary by 10%. Good news. So how do we do with awk? I know it's pretty simple in any database language using SQL and PLSQL, but awk can also do it. So just need to see, it's awk. Okay, this is for search. I'll go back. This is my example for so to print $1 and $2, okay, and we'll also print new sal with increment in 1.10. So this means hike of 10%. So if I multiply something with its 1.10, it is 10%. If it is 20%, I just need to do 1.20. So we are just giving, we'll give a hike of 10% here. Okay, so if I do this, I'll get an option. So I see that after $1, there is no gap. Okay, so I'll just fix it here. So I'll say $1, shift, space, $2, and new cell. So originally, this it has multiplied original cell by 10. Let's do a quick check. So let's see, the new cell for Kevin is 3300. Okay, let's do a grep Kevin and cell data. The existing salary of Kevin was 3000, which is now changed to 3300. So this is how we can use awk to apply some mathematics. Another example that I would like to show you is, you know, this we have already seen. Let's take this. So sal data. So printing more than one column and picking out specific columns. So this is just action. Okay. So it just picked all the names. So first name and the second name, because first name is $2 and second name is $3. The most important thing I missed to update you is, like, awk, when I give awk, when I run awk, okay, so each column is taken up as a default internal variable and which is represented by $1, $2, $3, $4. So each column is gets a internal variable which is dollar. So $1 means first column, $2 means second, $3 means third column, $4 means fourth column. So that's what I mean here when I say print $2 and $3. That means it will print column 2 and column 3. And I've given a space and double quotes to add a space between the names. Now, I have already shown you the use of print 0. So if I say print 0, it will give all the columns. And we just saw an example of where salary is more than 10,000. Now there is a classic example that I will use with, we use awk sometimes with processes. So let's see output of our PS, PS-EAF. So in PS, there are some extern processes which are running that I want to figure out. I can do it by grep. PS-EAF grep extern. So I can see there are some extern processes running. I want to kill them, but before killing these processes, I have to. So one way is using kill all. Okay, I know that command. But there's another way where I can pick each of these processes and find it out using awk. So I'll say PS-EAF grep extern. I'll then pipe this output to awk. And do I have to search anything? I just need to search for pattern extern. Okay. and search for pattern x term, and then print dollar 2. See, column 2 is your PIDs. Done. So I got all the items, all the processes for x term process. If I have to kill them, all I need to do is pipe them to a command called xargs, and then the command is kill hyphen 9. So I'll give x, I'll pass on the arguments to kill hyphen 9 using xargs, and that's it. Once I do this and I try to figure my processes, this, sorry, I give the wrong command. There are no more xterm processes. This is the grep command itself. It's grep xterm. So these are some powerful way of searching and working with AWK. So let's take a look back. So search and print. So you can search and print a specific column. For example, I can do AWK search for Daniel and print everything. Let's see, print everything. What does it come with? Daniel on the file cell data. So I got two Daniels out here. So it gave me search and it gave me some action item. The another example I showed was awk and just updating the salary by 10%. So I executed the command. Then I used to just show some columns out of it. Then I also used awk to print zero all the columns. I have used a search and action where I tried to search for salary more than 10,000. And print that, print entire details. Let's run this again and see. So this is the output. And then I also show an example of using awk after, like using awk as an when taking input from a different command like a PS.